Russia witch hunt was a plan by those who lost the election to try and illegally regain power by framing innocent Americans, many of them. They suffered with an elaborate hoax. And this group of major losers did not just ruthlessly attack me, my family, and everyone who questioned their lies. They tried to divide our country, to poison the national debate, and to tear up the fabric of our great democracy, the greatest anywhere in the world.
The assault by the Obama administration and the mainstream media against Trump's allies has been potentially criminal. Trump associates have received death threats, lost fortunes from legal fees, and have had their reputations dragged through the mud, all because this Russia collusion hoax started by Hillary Clinton. Joining me now, former Trump campaign foreign policy advisor George Papadopoulos. He is the author of the new book, A Deep State Target, and former Trump campaign advisor Michael Caputo. All right, Michael, you were unmasked. You believe you were electronically surveilled. You also believe you had a human spy thrown at you. And now you've had to liquidate tens of thousands of dollars to pay for legal fees. How do you feel after all of this?
I want to go to Disney World. You know, I mean, I got to tell you, just it feels like vindication. It feels like, you know, the Super Bowl's over and we're the champs. We really went through a lot, all of us. And I mean, not just me and my family, my children. You know, my wife got a piece of a sniper rifle in the mail. It's just been a really dark two-year period. But there are dozens of us that went through this. A lot of them, you know, hiding out in the jungle, you know, didn't want to, you know, come out and talk to anyone. They're coming out of the jungle now like Japanese soldiers after World War II. We haven't spoken to each other at all in the last 2 years. And I think a lot is going to come to light in the weeks ahead.
Okay, so you feel totally vindicated, but you must feel a little taken advantage of because your own government, constitutional republic, there's supposed to be protections for privacy in there. You had a administration wiretap you, send spies to you, unmask you, totally violated your constitutional rights just because you were in another party. I mean, this goes beyond dirty tricks. I mean, this is criminal at the highest levels.
I believe so, too. I believe that a lot of crimes were committed. You know, I was a marginal character in this situation. You know, kind of I was in front of the House and the Senate and interrogated by Mueller. But it wasn't until some of this news came out on people like Carter Page and George Papadopoulos, what was being thrown at them. You know, I feel like my country failed me, but my country really failed the likes of George Papadopoulos and Carter Page. And if you read George Papadopoulos's book, it reads like a novel. You know, it reads like a John le Carré novel. It's a page turner. But it really happened, and it never should have.
Yeah, I mean, this was a spy novel, and the mainstream media has no interest in it, because if this had been on the other side, there would have been Pulitzers coming out of their ears. George, you also had contact with spies, multiple spies. When you were abroad, you were surveilled. You were set up, you believe, to participate in this thing which launched the investigation, Crossfire Hurricane. Do you believe at all that you even talked to anybody that was a Russian asset, or was it all Western assets?
That's a great question, Jesse, and thanks a lot for having me on. As you'll probably see in my book, you know, I named five assets and spies that were thrown my way from three different countries in four different cities. My entire case was a fabrication to make it by Western intelligence organizations, the CIA, the Obama Department of Justice, and corrupt FBI officials, and even foreign countries such as the United Kingdom and Australia and even Italy, who are in on this, to make it look like I and probably others were involved in a conspiracy with Russians, but I never met a single Russian during my time on the campaign or even in my entire professional life.
Wow.
That's how incredible this PSYOP was against the American people for the last 2 years.
Do you think that they did that to justify gaining access into the Trump campaign through the back door?
Well, look, this disinformation campaign that was unfortunately propagated on the American people for the last 2 years is certainly what happened. What happened is, I think this was completely pre-planned. I know Devin Nunes has recently come out and stated that there was an active investigation into the Trump campaign by late 2015, early 2016.
Wow.
So this July 31st date, in my opinion, is completely artificial. I think that's some sort of cover story.
I believe you're right about that, because this article that broke this whole counterintelligence operation in the New York Times, that was right before the IG report came out. So that was, they were running interference for the FBI and for the CIA, and those were all leaks to justify the campaign. I believe, I agree with you, it happened way, way earlier. And you say in the book that Mueller got you to plead to a perjury charge because he threatened you with a much higher charge of, you know, not registering as a foreign agent.
Yeah, that's actually that's something very important. I want everybody to understand what Mueller and the FBI and all these intelligence organizations were actually after me for were my ties to Israel. I don't understand how somebody like me, who's never met a Russian in his life, got caught up in some sort of Russia conspiracy. But by the time the FBI came to my house in January of 2017, they were basically threatening me about my ties to Israel. And then formally later on, Mueller's telling me that we're going to charge you with FARA violations if you don't plead guilty.
I mean, those are some serious strong arm tactics. And I just want the audience to recognize what you just said. George Papadopoulos, who, you know, the New York Times says started this entire investigation, has never spoken to a Russian agent ever. They were all FBI informants, CIA informants. Let that sink in. All right, Mike, George, good luck with everything. I'm glad you guys can come out of the jungle and talk to each other. Good luck.
Thanks a lot. I appreciate it.